ஸ்ரீ குருப்போ நம. குருர் பிரம்மா குருர் விஷ்ணு குருர் தேவோ மகேஸ்வர குரு சாட்சாத் பரம்பிரம்மா தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நம. குரவே சர்வலோகானாம் விஷஜே புவரோகிணாம் நிதயே சர்வவித்யானாம் ஸ்ரீ தட்சிணாமூர்த்தயே நம. வக்ரதுண்ட மகாகாய சூரியகோடி சமப்ரபா நிர்விக்னம் குருமே தேவ சர்வகாரியேஷு சர்வதா கஜானனம் பூதகணாதிசேவிதம் கவித்தயம் பூபலசாரபக்ஷிதம் உமாசுதம் சோகவிநாசகாரணம் நமாமி விக்னேஸ்வர பாதபங்கஜம். சுக்லாம்பரதரம் விஷ்ணம் சசிவருடம் சதுர்புஜம் பிரசன்னபதனம் தியாயே சர்வவிக்னோபசாந்தயே. வியாசம் அஷ்டரப்தாரம் சக்தே போத்ரமகல்மஜம் பராசராத்மஜம் வந்தே சுகதாதம் தபோநிதிம் வியாசாய விஷ்ணுரூபாய வியாசரூபாய விஷ்ணவே நமோ வைப்ரஹ்மணதே வாசிஷ்டாய நமோ நம. நாராயணம் நமஸ்கிருத்ய நரம் சைவ நரோத்தமம் தேவீம் சரஸ்வதீம் வியாசம் ததோ ஜெயமுதீரயே. So last week we looked at how four Pandavas, after completing their conquest in four directions, they returned to Kandavaprastha, and then Yudhishthira, consulting Krishna, decided to do the Rajasoya sacrifice. They prepared everything for the sacrifice and invited all the kings, all the people from all over the world came to that sacrifice and brought enormous amount of wealth as well as gift to Yudhishthira. And the sacrifice was about to conclude, and the final part of that sacrifice was to do the Argya, offer the worship to all the people, and Yudhishthira asks whom to start with, and Bhishma suggests start with Krishna. And when Sahadeva starts, goes to Krishna with his Argya tray, with water and everything, one person stops him, Shishupala. Shishupala stops him, and Shishupala says that, addressing Yudhishthira, he says that why Krishna is being worshipped first? When all these kings and rishis and brahmanas and everybody is assembled, why he is being worshipped? You are still a child. You don't know what his morality is. Morality is very subtle. You don't know that. So because of this, Bhishma, who does not have any knowledge, and he is already breaking all the rules of morality, you are following his guidance, and this Bhishma should be scolded for that. Okay, Krishna is not even a king, let alone him being a great king or great person, deserves the first worship. He is not even a king. And if you consider, you want to worship somebody old and things, worship Vasudeva. Vasudeva is Krishna's father here. And or if you want somebody to worship who is your well-wisher, worship Drupada. If you want a guru, worship Dronacharya. If you want a brahmana, worship Kripa or Daumya or Vyasa or even Ashwatthama, who all know all the Vedas and all the branches of Vedas. They know everything. If you want somebody strong, worship Duryodhana or Bhishmakar, Shalya, Rukmi, Ekalavya, or anyone of them. Worship any of them. But why Krishna? Krishna, he is not a priest. He is not a king. He is nothing. He is... why are you worshipping him? He keeps challenging, and then he says that, Yudhishthira, you abandoned entire dharma today by thinking that you can offer Argya first to Krishna. This Krishna is unworthy of offering any respect. Don't worship him. Okay, he is like a dog that goes, and whenever it gets a little bit of sweet or something, ghee or something, it starts running around and thinking it achieved something. Krishna is such a person. He doesn't even know what is insult and what is respect. If somebody insults him, he also thinks that that is his respect. And having said that, Shishupala stood up from his seat, and there are some kings assembled there. They also stood up. They thought Shishupala is saying the right thing, and they also stood up. At this, Yudhishthira runs to him and says, ask the Shishupala, don't go. In fact, Krishna, and also don't insult Bhishma here, because he is the most aged person here, and everyone respects Bhishma, and Bhishma knows everything about Krishna, so don't insult. At that time, Bhishma himself speaks, saying that anyone that disapproves worship to Krishna who is the oldest person of this verse, this universe, because he is the creator of the entire universe. He is the oldest. They don't reserve any soft words. So he tells, Bhishma tells Yudhishthira that don't go and beg Shishupala to stay in this sacrifice or not speak anything, because he doesn't deserve it. Krishna is the oldest. He is the one that deserves. Okay. And he says that there is no Kshatriya on this planet who Krishna cannot defeat. And even when Krishna defeats, he gives them their life back. He gives them their wealth back. He gives them their kingdom back. And he forgives them. So that kind of behavior, you don't see in any of human beings. And Krishna has that energy. This whole universe is around him. It's because of him. It runs around because of him. So that's why we worship Krishna as the oldest, and he is the best. So again, he says, he tries to tell Shishupala that don't speak like that lightly of Krishna. You don't understand him. I have listened to many, many wise men who all talked about Krishna's greatness and who Krishna is. I know this. So among all the people, everything that's on this, you see, Krishna is the first and he is the Hari and he should be worshipped first. And he says that Krishna is, who should be worshipped? Bhishma again explains who should be worshipped. So he says that among Brahmanas, if there are a lot of Brahmanas sitting around, you should worship first the one who has the superior knowledge. If there are a lot of Kshatriyas sitting, you worship the one who has the most strength. Among Vaishyas, you worship the one who has the most wealth and possessions and wealth. And among Shudras, if there are a lot of Shudras assembled, and worship among them goes to the oldest one. Whoever is the superior in years, that person deserves the worship first. So here again, Krishna, he is the priest. And Krishna, why we worship here Krishna? Because of two reasons, Bhishma says. One is, he has the knowledge of Vedas, because Krishna, Bhishma knows that Krishna is the source of all the Vedas. So he says that he is the knowledge of Vedas, and he is also he is excess in strength. So if you are thinking about a Kshatriya, he is the excess. There is no one who can defeat him. And also he talks about Krishna's character. He is liberal, clever, knowledge in Vedas, and he is brave, modest, and his achievements, Krishna's achievements, his excellent intelligence, humility, beauty, firmness, contentment, prosperity, all these exist in Krishna. And Krishna is the sacrificial priest. That means he is the priest who can conduct the sacrifices. He is the guru. He is the one who you can give your daughter to. Normally, you don't give your daughter to somebody who is not worthy. You do everything with anybody, but normally when you give your daughter, you always think 100 times whether that person is of good character or not. So here Bhishma says that if you are willingly give it, Krishna is somebody whom you would happily give your daughter to, because he is such a good character. He is a snataka. That means he follows all the vratas and everything. And he is the king. He is the king of the entire universe. And he is a friend. And that's why we should worship Achyuta. And then again, Bhishma explains who Krishna is. I'm going a little bit more into these details, reading every line, because this explains who Krishna is. Again, you will hear again most of these things again in Bhagavad Gita. There is a chapter where Krishna himself says who he is. But here Bhishma explains who Krishna is. So Krishna again, Bhishma explains that Krishna is the origin of the universe. He is the origin. He is the one where entire universe goes and dissolves at the end. Okay, it all starts from him and goes back to him. And everything that's mobile, immobile, anything that moves and doesn't move, so all the animals, humans, everything, and anything that doesn't move, whatever you see that doesn't move, trees or mountains or whatever it is, all those things created by him. They all started from him and exist from him. And he says that there is nothing beyond him. So the intellect, the seat of sensibility, and the five elements, that is the air, the fire, water, space, earth, all these five elements, and the four types of species, okay, the living beings. That's the one that lays eggs, the one that's born out of the womb, the one that's born in the damp and filthy places, and the vegetables, all those things established by Krishna. The sun, moon, the stars, the planets, the directions, the main directions, north, east, south, west, the main directions, and the directions in between, all this are established in Krishna. So again, it is, Bhishma says, everything is in Krishna. Whatever you see is in Krishna. And he says that as the Agnihotra is among the foremost of Vedic sacrifices. So if somebody is maintaining the fire, that means Agnihotra, that means every day, three times, they offer ghee into the fire and maintain that fire continuously, there is no other sacrifice they need to do, because that's the best sacrifice that one can do. And as Gayatri is among the most meters, so chandas, okay, where my Vedic mantras have their own meters, okay, so that meters, Gayatri is the sacred. King is among the best among the men, and ocean is among all the water bodies, and moon is among all the night sky, whatever you see, among all of them, stars and everything, moon is the best. Sun is among the all the things that shines, and Meru is the mountain that's among the best. Garuda is among all the birds. Like that, there is only Keshava who is best among all the worlds. Even in heaven, there is no one else like that. So this Shishupala is still a boy. Again, look here. Shishupala was telling Yudhishthira that he is a child and he doesn't know. And here comes Bhishma, another even older person than Shishupala, who comes and says, this Shishupala is still a boy. He doesn't know Krishna. Okay. So how changes? This changes. So then Shishupala listening to this. So at that time, Sahadeva, who was having the Argya plate in his hand to offer worship to Krishna, he says that if anybody does not agree, I will let my foot go on their head. Okay, that's kind of insulting everybody that in that assembly, saying that I will keep my foot on your head. That means I'm going to kick you out. Okay, so he's saying that, he says Krishna is the guru, he is the father, he is the guru, he is everything, and that's why he deserves Argya. And then saying that, Sahadeva keeps his foot forward. And at that time, from sky, the flowers fall on Sahadeva, and there's a voice says, in the voice in the sky says, excellent, excellent. And then Narada, who was watching all this, says that any person who does not worship Krishna should be regarded as dead. Even though they are moving, speaking, they are doing all the things, they should be regarded as dead and should never be talked. Okay, so that such a person, one should never be talked to on any occasions. So Narada's this statement is very important, because it says again that if somebody does not worship Krishna, they should be moved, regarded as dead. And then with this, Sahadeva starts to offer Argya to Krishna, and he, looking at this, Shishupala becomes even more angry. He tells the kings who stood up with him, telling that the only way to stop this insult, because Shishupala considered this as an insult. When he was there and all the other kings were there, Krishna is being worshipped. So he thinks Yudhishthira insulted. So he says that we have to attack these people. Let's get our arrows and swords and all the weapons. Let's attack these people. And looking at that, so Yudhishthira becomes a little bit worried. He goes to Bhishma and asks, what can we do now? Because these people are preparing to attack, and I want sacrifice to conclude peacefully, and also I want to make sure that nobody is hurt in my sacrifice. I don't want any people that assembled here getting hurt because of some arguments among us. So Yudhishthira thinking about all the other people. So Bhishma at that time says that, don't worry, he's just a barking dog. Dog can go and bark at a sleeping lion, but once the lion wakes up, dog will not take another breath. So he's talking about Krishna here, saying that Krishna is very quiet. You just let Shishupala do what he does. Don't worry about all these things, because he says that everything exists in Krishna, and he's watching, and he's here. He's going to look after Shishupala. So hearing that, Shishupala becomes even more angrier now at Krishna, sorry, at Bhishma. Okay, so originally he was very angry. He was not happy that Krishna was offered Arjuna. So he scolded Yudhishthira. And now, because Bhishma said, Shishupala is like a dog barking, he becomes angry and he says that this old man doesn't know anything and he doesn't, he's in a third state. That means he's not even brahmachari, he's not even grihastha, he's not even sannyasa, he's living somewhere in another state. He's like just going wherever the Kuru family goes. He's like a boat tied to boat. Okay, so that boat doesn't know where it's going. It's just following the another boat that's carrying it. Blind following a blind, like that. So he says that this person doesn't know anything. He's arrogant, ignorant. And by talking about Krishna and reminding us about Krishna's acts like killing Putana and others, he's just made us even more angry. And Krishna, when he was young, he might have killed few people. That doesn't make him any great. Okay, anything can happen. So anybody can do anything. So Krishna is not great. And he even killed Kamsa. Kamsa was his maternal uncle. How can he kill somebody whom he actually lived in his kingdom and he was in his kingdom? So Shishupala says that those who are virtuous and wise says that if you eat somebody's food, okay, so one must never take weapons against women, cows, brahmanas, and the person whom from you have food. Okay, so if you eat in somebody's food, somebody's house, or somebody fed you food, you should never raise your weapons against them. So Shishupala here says, when the rules are like that, dharma is like that, when you have to never raise weapons against women, cows, brahmanas, and the one who has fed you, Krishna went and killed Kamsa. So that itself is against the dharma, and you're worshipping him for that. So he says, all the teachings that has been done all these years has been thrown away just because you wanted to praise, help worship Krishna and benefit from it. You are doing that. This Krishna has killed a woman, talking about Putana, and is so this Krishna does not deserve worship. Again and again, he keeps saying about that. And then finally, he says that you are just doing this because you are trying to benefit something from Krishna. Nothing else. So you think he has wealth and things. That's why you want to benefit and that's what you are doing. You have fallen from this path and Bhishma, you are old, but you don't have any knowledge. You don't have any sense. You can't think properly. He uses all the things and he says that you have lost dharma when you took Amba into Hastinapura. That Amba who was planning to marry somebody else. And you took him for your brother Vichitravirya. And then you just left her somewhere in the middle. You did not marry her to anybody. So you just living like you broke dharma many, many times. And then he again says that you are living as a brahmachari. Okay. So you are not married. You don't have children. And that means your life is useless. So he says again, Shishupala says here, worship, gift, study, sacrifice, distinguished by law, gift to brahmanas. All these are equal to 1/16th of a merit of having a son. Okay, so that means having a son, as I said this many times before, having a son means 7 generations before and after will get from Pitraloka, they will get fed and they will go to heaven, right? So that's why he says you did not marry and you don't have children. So all the worship, gift, study, and looking after the brahmanas, gift to brahmanas, everything you did is useless, okay? Because you are childless, you don't have children. So he insults Shishupala like this. He again goes about Krishna and Bhima and others' activities in what they did with Jarasandha. Again, he talks about how they went to Jarasandha's place. from the back door, and then disguised as Brahmanas. When Jarasandha offered them food there and other service, they did not accept, and they killed him. Okay, even Jarasandha did not think that Krishna was great. That's why he chose Bhima for a fight, somebody equal. So Shishupala continues like that, insulting everybody. Bhishma, Krishna, Yudhishthira, everyone he starts insulting. At this, Bhima becomes very angry. His eyes becomes red and he becomes like this. You can see lines coming in his face. His teeth were grunting. When Bhima was like that, he was about to jump on Shishupala and beat him. Bhishma stops him and says, calm down, calm down. Don't rush anything. Okay. So, and looking at this, Shishupala says, Bhima, come on, come on, come and fight me. If you really have strength, come and fight me. Okay. Because Shishupala knew that Bhima was stopped by Bhishma. So he was saying, come and fight me. He was challenging him. And then at that time, Bhishma says, Bhishma explains about Shishupala, who Shishupala is, and why he is like this. So Bhishma explains a story of how Shishupala was born. He says that Shishupala was born for the Chedi king, and he was born with four arms and a third eye. Okay. So he was born with a third eye and four arms. And when he was born, he started screaming like a donkey. And when he was born like that, his parents, father, mother, everybody, they were very worried about it and his birth, because it was not good sign that a child getting birth and screaming like a donkey with all the four arms and the odd looking third eye. So at that time, they hear a voice. Okay, so they were about to abandon that child. And at that time, they hear a voice that said that this son will become very strong person. So don't worry about him. And he will not die in childhood. Okay, his time is not come yet, but he will be. So, and one that he will kill him, okay, has also been born. So the one person that's going to kill him is also been born, but this Shishupala is not going to die in his childhood. He's going to go strong. He's going to grow strong, and at some point he will get. Hearing this, what his mother does is, can you tell me how he's going to be killed? So this is a weird thing, because no mother normally wants to know how their children are going to be killed. Here, Shishupala's mother, she was very anxious. She hears some voice. She was about to abandon her child. And then she hears a voice saying that, don't do that. And then she asks how this child is going to be killed. And then the invisible voice that says from the sky is saying, whenever you place this child on someone's lap, if the arms and eyes disappear, that person will kill. So hearing this, they wanted to know who this person is. So all the kings and princes and strong men, whoever were there, they were all coming there, and they used to place this child, Shishupala, on their lap. And the arms and eyes did not drop. And like that, they were trying and trying. And after some time, when hearing that the child was born from Dwaraka, Krishna and Balarama, they went there. So they went to Chedi, because that Chedi king's wife is Yadava daughter. Okay, she is from Yadavas. So they went there, and they went. And when the baby was given to Krishna, the baby was on Krishna's lap, suddenly the arms and eyes disappeared. And looking at this, his mother asks him that, do not kill him. Please don't kill him. And Krishna says that, Krishna makes a promise that, don't worry, I know what, I will not kill this person until he makes 100 mistakes. Okay, till he makes 100 offenses, mistakes, I will not kill him. I will forgive him 100 times. So Bhishma, narrating this story to Bhima, tells him that, don't worry, Krishna is watching. Everything has come out of Krishna. Shishupala is an energy of Krishna, and Shishupala will go back to Krishna. when time is right, he will go back. So again, Kamsa and Shishupala, they were Jaya Vijayas. So if you hear the stories, Hiranyaksha, Hiranyakashipu, and then Ravana, Kumbhakarna, and then here in Kamsa and Shishupala, they were Jaya Vijayas taking birth on earth because of curse. So that's the background. So here again, Shishupala. So Bhishma says that when Shishupala continues to abuse him, Bhishma says that there is no king on earth who can defeat him. And everybody is like, for him, Bhishma, he says that everybody on this assembly who is assembled, except Krishna, is for me, they are like a blade of grass. I can destroy that very quickly. And is hearing that, everybody, all the kings there becomes angry, very angry. Okay. So then once they become angry, they challenge Krishna for a battle. Okay. So Bhishma says, if you are really angry, fight with Krishna. So they challenge Krishna. And Krishna, Shishupala again continues to insult, saying that, okay, all the people that's assembled there, why they are not worshipped and why Krishna should be worshipped and things like that. And so hearing that, so Shishupala, all those things saying, and then Krishna stands up and he says, Krishna says that this Shishupala, I forgave him so many times and I could have killed him many, many times before. But this is such a person that even though he's, because he was married to Yadava's daughter, sorry, he's born to Yadava's daughter, and I made a promise I did not kill him. He burnt Dwaraka while we were away in Prajyotisha, and he stole the sacrificial horse of my father, and he took Akrura's wife on her way while she was returning, while she was going from Dwaraka to Soviras, and dressing himself as Karusha, king of Karusha, he went to king's the Karusha king's bride called Bhadra and spent time with her. So all these things I tolerated because I made a promise. I made a promise to my father's sister, that is Shishupala's mother, and that's why I did not kill him. And this Shishupala is even wanted to marry Rukmini, and Rukmini finally married me. So hearing this, Shishupala laughs. Are you not ashamed to say that your wife wanted to marry me, or I wanted to marry your wife? Are you not ashamed to tell that in this assembly of all the kings? And Shishupala insults more and more. At this, Krishna thinks about his discus. He brings his finger up and the discus comes. And with that chakra, he cuts Shishupala's head. So Shishupala killed in that assembly. And all the kings who saw this, they were shocked and they went quiet after this. So, and then Yudhishthira orders his brothers to do all the final rites of Shishupala with respect and install Shishupala's son as the king right there. And with all the obstacles removed, Yudhishthira completes his sacrifice as which was overseen by Krishna and Bhishma and others. And all the kings assembled there, they congratulate Yudhishthira and they say that they are going to leave. And Yudhishthira orders his brothers and children to make sure that everybody leaves with proper respect. So Drishtadyumna arranges all the things that needed for King Virata. Arjuna goes to send Drupada, Bhima sends Bhishma, Dhritarashtra, Drona, Ashwatthama, everybody. And Nakula follows King of Sulava, King Sulava. And then Draupadi's sons and Arjuna, Subhadra's son, that is Abhimanyu, they follow all the other kings who came there. And all the Brahmanas that assembled there were also worshipped and were sent with large amount of gifts. After everyone leaves, Krishna prepares to leave to Dwaraka. And he informs Yudhishthira, Kunti, Arjuna, Draupadi, and everybody and Subhadra that he is leaving, and then he starts his return journey to Dwaraka. So, and he tells Yudhishthira that look after your people, like Indra protects everybody, protect them. And with that, all the kings who came there, all the people who arrived at Indraprastha, they leave Indraprastha, except Duryodhana and Shakuni, who wanted to spend a little bit more time in Indraprastha and explore the city. Okay, sightseeing. They wanted to go on a sightseeing in Indraprastha and enjoy the luxury in Pandava's time, Pandava's city. Okay, so we will stop there this week and we will see what happens in the next set of chapters, which is called Dyuta Parva. We'll see that from next week. Any questions today? Okay, if none, thank you. We will see you all next week. Thank you.